I mean, as you can see today, the turnout has been amazing, and like the support and the love for the family. Claudia in particular has been absolutely so strong, and I mean, she's just tireless. She just keeps going on and on and on. I mean, and they've been so dismissive of the family. Nobody's rang the family or come to see them. They've got Henry's possessions that they've refused to give back. They've got his mobile phone, they've got his, you know, his clothes that she was promised last week they'd pick them up. Haven't picked them up. You know, I mean, there was unmarked police cars that chased him. They had no lights on, so obviously Henry didn't know they were police. And this will all come out in the court case, you know. And what's amazing is that something so terrible, they've turned it into something so positive, like by setting up the Henry Hicks Foundation. And already they've helped three families that have lost young people towards burying their loved one. And I'm a trustee of that charity. They've asked me to come.
That's right, we're aware of that. I mean, we think it's a very, very positive thing for people to do in the fraternity that you're from. Now, I actually live on the street, funnily enough. And
on this street, do you?
I live actually at the junction where Henry passed
where
away.
It happened.
And I can tell you that firsthand, and it's unusual for me to do this with a microphone in my hand, but they were abusive to me. They were rude to me. They asked me if I was a journalist, and I said, well, actually, I live here.
Was this when Henry just died?
The 99. Yeah, they were very rude. I also had a policeman laughing about it. He thought it was funny.
Well, they did exactly the same to the Hicks family, because they wouldn't let the family get to Henry. They refused to take him to the hospital, yet they took people that were in the minicab home. So, they laughed at Dion when she said, will you take me to the police station? Will you take me to the hospital? They laughed at her and said, I'm not going to take you. I mean, it's disgusting the way they've treated the family. Really is.
Well, there's two other issues that really bothered me enormously. On the actual day, they didn't clear away properly the remnant that was left.
No.
And the following morning, I woke up early to the sound of people getting buckets of hot water from a very elderly neighbour, washing the remains on the street, and I saw the remains passing my door.
Yeah.
I was very upset myself, but I was determined that we need to fight this sort of issue. It needs to be fought in the media.
Well, the reason that the neighbours did that is because they didn't want the Hicks family to see, you know, the blood and everything that was left
from
Henry.
Yeah. I mean, all the neighbours on the estate, they're very upset by it. They're very positive towards the family and the people who've been suffering, who've been coming there. You know, they've been great people. You know,
they
clean
really
up after themselves.
Yep.
There's none of this mess or anything. You know, there's
bin
bags there,
amazing.
They're looking after it. Fresh flowers all the time. Only yesterday, Claudia turned up, some beautiful fresh flowers. You know, no one's going to let this go anytime too soon.
No, it's not. They won't stop until they get the justice they need. They really won't. I know. They've been, when you think what they've been through, you know, it's only just over 3 months now. And, you know, we see Dion and we see David. And out of everybody, it's David that I think is struggling the most, because Dion has got a lot of friends around her. David's finding it particularly hard. He's just wandering around. He's just lost, you know, like. And I mean, your heart breaks for all of the family, but in particular, I think David's struggling more so than anyone, really.
But maybe, again, an unusual move for TV crew to say such a thing, but it's a locality to us. It's our locality. It's where we live.
Yeah.
We're concerned, and we've made David the offer, and he's accepted that. If he wants us to go with him, if he prefers the meetings to be recorded, we'll be there for him.
Oh,
we don't want anything for this.
Yeah,
we're
no.
prepared to back David
to
the hilt.
Well done to you. I know.
So
yeah,
we're going to
well
be strongly behind him, and we know the massive things you've done yourself. You know, hats off to you for the things you're doing, and everybody else in the fraternity that puts themselves forward for this. One thing I would like to say to you is, yesterday while they were going to paint the mural, with all the appropriate permissions in place, several police officers turned up. I've seen the footage on the mobile phone taken by Claudia. It's a disgrace.
It really is. I know. Is that normal for 6 police officers and 4 police cars to turn up if someone's doing what they thought was graffiti when they'd got permission? I know, yeah. I'd love to have seen their faces when she gave them the permission slip.
Yeah. Well, again, it's an ongoing thing, and that commander has promised to engage the family. Number one, she's not done that today.
No.
And that is, quite frankly, a disgrace to the crowd. They were not
well,
happy
really
about it.
It's really dismissive, isn't it, of the family? It really, really is. When you think what they've been through, not to, for somebody to come out. I know. They had policemen on the rooftops watching to see what was going on, but then they didn't have the guts to come out and confront
they
everyone.
They probably weren't told about it.
I know, yeah. Oh, well, thank you for all you're doing. Thank you.
Thank you for all your time. And if you feel you want to put anything forward at all, contact Claudia. Ask for IFN Media. We'll be in touch with you, and we'll get this right to the very end.
Oh, yeah.
Right
we'll
outside
the
Royal Courts of Justice.
I know, we'll all be there. Fine.
We're going to be there for you, okay?
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed for your time.
Thank you, lovely to meet you. Thank you.